The aim of this experiment, determination of refractive index for E-ray and O-ray using double image prism. Now we see the apparatus required for this experiment. This is a sodium lamp, this is a negative calcite prism, and this is a spectrometer. Now we see the part of this spectrometer. This is a collimator, this is a prism table, this is a 2 vernier scale, and this is a telescope. Now we see how to set up the spectrometer. Rays of light coming from light source and entering through the slit into collimator, and after that into telescope. Next, with the help of slit screw, we get a narrow slit. Focus the telescope on a distance object. The distance between the position of a focusing point of the objective and eyepiece, the emerged ray parallel, diverge or converge. When the emerged rays parallel, the image becomes sharp, otherwise we will get blur. After focusing the telescope for parallel rays, we will get a sharp image of distance object. Now this setting of telescope is not disturbed throughout the experiment. Adjust the level of this prism table. Telescope can be freely moved before the tightening the telescope fixing screw. Tighten the telescope fixing screw. Tighten the telescope fixing screw, then it will not move from the position. For a particular source of light, we are getting a sharp image of the slit by moving collimator and adjusting the slit width. Now we will discuss the definition of E-ray and O-ray. When an unpolarized light is incident on bifringent material, it is split into two types of polarized rays. One of these rays has polarization in a direction perpendicular to the optical axis and other in the direction of the optical axis of the medium, which is called extraordinary rays. We will see how to take readings in second vernier scale. The main scale of every spectrometer is graduated from 0 to 360 degree and mark as 0, 10, 20 up to 360 degree. Usually each 10 degree portion is further divided into 20 division. This value of one main scale division, 10 divided by 20 is 0.5, is equals to 30. Zero of vernier scale coincide with main scale. Check the vernier scale division which is best coincide with main scale division.
To find the angle of prism, first of all set the spectrometer as explained in part number first. Generally, we are using monochromatic light to find angle of prism. Never use mercury light to find angle of prism, otherwise dispersion will come. Get the narrow and fine slit as explained in part first. In this axis of telescope and collimator should be horizontal. Every spectrometer prism is having two polished faces and one graduated faces. Now put the rough surface towards the telescope and edge just opposite to the rough surface towards the collimator. Rotate the telescope to the left side of the prism. Fix the telescope where the image of slit coincide with the crosswire of the eyepiece and note the reading. Rotate the telescope to the other side of the prism. Fix the telescope where the image of slit coincide with the crosswire of the eyepiece and note the reading. Every spectrometer prism is having an angle of 60 degree. When we calculate, generally its reading comes between 59 to 61 degree.
Now we will see the minimum deviation of prism using sodium light. Keep the prism such as light from collimator inside at small angle at the one of the polished surface and after passes out of other polished surface as shown in animator. Move the telescope using telescope slider up to see the slit in the left side and make coincide the slit with the crosswire using fine angle adjusting slider. Now prism table is rotated in such a manner that the angle of deviation decrease when the position of minimum deviation reach, the image become stationary and further rotation of table make if move in the backward direction.
vernier of telescope to the stationary image. Note the reading from both the vernier V1 and V2. Minimum division of prism with the sodium light is calculated 51 degree 34 minutes. After refraction, refraction of double image prism, we will get to see two rays from telescope. These are E ray and O ray. The first ray is E ray and adjacent ray is O ray. This all about of refractive index of E ray and O ray using double image prism.